Roland Emmerich is a man who likes to destroy the world. His films span genres and universes, with Stargate, Godzilla, The Patriot, Universal Soldier, The Day After Tomorrow, 2012, 10,000 BC, and White House Down all on his resume. He's gone on to become one of the most successful filmmakers ever, thanks to a string of hits that have grossed over $3 billion worldwide. But he has never made a sequel, until now.
They like to get the landmarks.
Going back 20 years ago when you were coming up with the story for Independence Day, you guys already had a hit on your hand with Universal Soldier. It went on to become one of the highest grossing movies ever made. You guys were on the cover of Time, with Aliens, were on the cover of Time magazine for goodness sakes.
Aliens.
Technically, you could have been in the suit, who knows? Did you have any idea about the kind of phenomenon this was going to become?
No, I was like super surprised.
I read that you experienced open racism in Hollywood when you were attempting to cast Will Smith in the lead role originally.
Well, it was the studio was just not like very happy about my choice of Will Smith. They like kind of thought the part was not written African-American, so they kind of thought we can cast anybody in this part. And then all of a sudden, to their surprise, we had already made up our mind, because Dean and I saw a 6 degrees of separation, and we kind of loved this young actor, and we said, like, he's our guy, and we won out.
Now, you've experienced prejudice yourself as an openly gay man in Hollywood. Has it been frustrating for you, given that there are still obviously some deep-seated prejudices as well?
I made this movie Stonewall based on a trailer that wanted to boycott it.
We're an organization that fights for gay rights.
Will we ever see a Roland Emmerich blockbuster where there's a gay man or woman saving the world in the lead role, do you think?
Well, in the lead role, that will probably take a longer time, you know. But I made a first step in the Resurgence. I have an openly gay couple in the film, and nobody, you know, it's not even mentioned that they're gay, just accepted what it is.
Take us back to when you were growing up and when you were a kid and a young movie fan. What was the flick that captured your imagination?
Well, I remember I went with my brother Wolfgang, who was like kind of 5 years older, and he took me actually to 2001, the Kubrick film, which I had no idea what it meant, but it like kind of really blew my mind. When I kind of went to film school in Munich, everybody actually had like kind of Wim Wenders or Fassbinder as the hero. And I had just seen, you know, Close Encounters of the Third Kind in Paris and Star Wars. So my heroes were a little bit more across the Atlantic. I was like a little bit, you know, an outsider because of that.
Will we ever see a Roland Emmerich romantic comedy, do you think?
I think romantic comedy is not like kind of that in anymore, right? There was a time when there was always like 3 or 4 big romantic comedies a year, and where are they?
Julia Roberts is doing other things,
maybe,
man.
Well, maybe you have to kind of have like a romantic comedy between two Marvel characters, and that would be maybe a new idea.
I would watch that.
You know, like kind of they exchange capes and
Bucky,
you know,
and Steve Rogers, like,
and go wild.
That would be great. Can you direct that, please? Well, look, Roland Emmerich, thank you so much for destroying the world. Thank you so much for chatting to us.
Okay.
It's been fantastic.
Okay.
Thank you.
Very good.
Excellent.